Hello and welcome to Cooney Cooks, the dumbest cooking show on YouTube. Yeah, and also I want to prove how it is that there are so few German restaurants around. So, today we are going to cook or prepare Handkäs with Musik, which is translating to hand cheese with music. And we need, of course, some hand cheese, or also called Harzer sometimes. Yeah, the recipe that I'm using is calling for one onion pear cheese, but there are bigger cheeses around, so these are like the medium size ones, so probably a little bit too much onion there. Then we need apple wine, wine, just for the marinade as well as for the cook and for eating it. Then we need some kind of vinegar, but usually best is to have some apple vinegar. Really good for the taste, but you could use any kind of vinegar. And then we need some oil. I think olive oil is not quite the best one, but it's the one I have around. Some bread for consuming it afterwards. Some dark German kind of bread is preferable. And then some cumin or pepper. I forget to buy cumin, so pepper it is. For the topping afterwards. So let's talk a little bit about hand cheese or hand käse. This is a sour milk cheese, which is popular around, or is not quite popular. It's quite stinky. So this is a cheese which is found around the area of South Hesse and also around the center of Germany, so Thuringer, Hesse. This one is called Harzer here, not Handkäse, right? So the legend is that you traditionally formed them with your hands, where they get this kind of form. And it's a sour milk cheese, so they have very high concentration of protein, like about 98%, I think. So, quite nice sports food overall. They just have, the odor is hard to get used to, as well as the taste. So that's maybe a downside. So the recipe I'm using is very simple. They say like 8 tablespoons of vinegar and 4 tablespoons of both the wine and the oil, so but without specifying which kind you should use. So, but this can be, it's down to your own taste. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's the vinegar. Let's go with the wine. Run for the cook. And this is apple wine from Frankfurt. So it's about original. But yeah, German wine. It's not like cider. It's more like mixture of wine and beer. This is about 4. This and then 4 spoons of oil. You can also do it without oil if you don't want so much fat in it. For sportier sides. Some people might point out that oil and water does not mix so well overall. Especially if you only have a spoon to stir it, but yeah. So, and then we have to cut the onions. Most people would cut them very small, probably what I'm going to try to do. So, see you in a second when it's done. The two onions already put us in a state where it's an almost solid solution, so I think I'll omit the other two onions and mix it a little bit more. And then we'll sparkle it over the cheeses. So, yeah. Probably smaller onions, weaker cheeses, depending. But it's all down to your personal taste. If you, of course, if you don't like raw onions, it's probably nothing you should ever try. I don't remember why I'm forbidden to do this at home, yeah? But not here so far. So we put the marinade onto the cheeses. And now you could either let them sit for like 5 minutes or several hours, depending on how much you want to it to go in the cheese. But this is quite fresh cheese, so I give it a little bit longer to settle in. Some people say it's like best would be to use a cheese which is like what, 2 weeks past its best use before date. Yeah, I'm not 100% sure where the best date is there, but yeah, I'll let it sit and marinate, and then we'll make another glass of wine and try if it's eatable. It's already, it's like if you're here, it's not even smelling bad due to so much smell being around. And I'm not tearing up, so that's quite positive. And yeah, forgot, I can already put on some of the pepper here. Cumin. I think cumin is maybe better to avoid the music, because yeah, you might ask what the music would be. And yeah, according to law, it is probably what's going to happen, what your body is going to produce if you eat like 2 raw onions with wine and vinegar. So yeah, so it depends probably on your body. And I think all the 3 people which ever went near enough to me to check told me that there's no problem. So yeah, you're probably not getting too far too much from it. Hopefully. But yeah, it's Corona. We're all working at home, right? So, and we are wearing masks. So it's perfect dinner for that. So yeah, let's see how it turns out. So has been a good half hour of marinating around here for the cheese. So it's his time. Has already almost gone. Let's talk a little bit about the apple wine here, or Apfelwein, or Äpfelwein, if you call it in German. So this is from Frankfurt, and this is usually a can where you get it. It's called a bamble. So if you got a bamble of apple wine, it's very really hard to say in English and German. This is almost the same, yeah. This is from the good company Postman from Frankfurt. I think this is the major's office in Frankfurt, where whenever we win any football game, they are standing up there and getting greeted due to Frankfurt having the main international airport in Germany, of course, I think, and being a all around very important city, despite it being quite small. So, yeah, you would get a bamble and usually drink it from a cup, the Irden cup, or such. And the taste is like a mixture of beer, wine, and vomit. It has like 5.5% of alcohol, so about the same as German beer has. So some people would call the taste quite nasty. Prosit. Now I'm getting called out for my fake German accent once more, yeah. So should use a good German bread. Darker variant probably, and yeah, we could try to get it on here with get the cheese on with the bread, but we're trying the spoon. So yeah, older cheese would be preferable, most people say like 2 weeks after the best use before date. It's really good, but hard to eat on the camera because so much onions are falling off. So yeah, it it's taste you have to get used to. It's probably not compatible with most people, but it's very very healthy and superfood almost. But we can destroy this with the alcohol and the apple wine, of course. So, yeah, if you try this out, let me know if it had any side effects of unforeseen nature. And yeah, especially let me know, is there sour cheese, a sour milk cheese around in your area? So I've heard from people making their own apple juice, apple wine, which is probably much better than this one. Well, tastes better. It's not better, of course, because this is the original. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video and the recipe. And yeah, I'll go and devour this here because yeah, I'm starved for this. I haven't had it in 4 years or something. So yeah, but I won't show you the that footage.